Hi, and welcome to episode 18 of my free Java video course. My name is Markus Biel. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the method finalize of the class object. The class object is the root of the class hierarchy. Every class in the whole Java universe inherits the methods of this class. So this is what makes those methods here very important, which is probably also the reason why those methods are very often used in Java developer job interview questions. So one way or the other, I hope I have not raised your attention. Also, you should know that this episode, as well as the following ones talking about all those methods, are based on the really great book Effective Java 2nd Edition from Joshua Block. I think I mentioned it already earlier. Now I have to say it again. Buy this book, read it. Even better would be if you read it twice. It's full of condensed information, advanced Java developer must know. My episode is supposed to give you an introduction to the topic, but for more detailed information, it's necessary that you read this book. Okay, so let's already start talking about the finalize method. The finalize method is actually a hook method. What is a hook method? A hook method is a method that there is an empty implementation provided in the class object. And the idea is that when you want this method to be used, you would provide an implementation in your own class by overwriting this method, and then this method will be called by the JVM. But before I go in more details, the most important takeaway from this episode is this method is flawed. So the best you can probably do, generally speaking, is not overwriting this method. So not using it, because it has its flaws. We'll, in this episode, see why. I mean, there are some few valid uses, at least according to Joshua Block. I can tell you, I'm developing in Java since 2001, so quite a few years already. I have never ever overwritten this method. So today is probably the first time to demonstrate you what it is, what it does. Okay, so maybe we should already jump into the code, because it might be easier to understand for you, or maybe before we read here this description. So the finalize method is called by the garbage collector of an object when garbage collection determines that there are no more references to the object. So again, next question is probably, what is the garbage collector? Well, the garbage collector is really a very cool thing of the Java language. Other languages such as C++ don't have it. As the name implies, it collects the garbage. What's the garbage? The garbage is or are objects that you created, worked on them, and after some time, the process will be finished, at least on certain objects. You will not need them anymore. And so it helps to free up those memory resources so that you hopefully never run into an out of memory exception. And this is all done behind the cover asynchronously by the garbage collector for you. But here is already the problem of the finalize method, because as said, it's called just before the garbage collector runs. The problem is the garbage collector is running asynchronously, so you can't influence when or if the garbage collector is running. It is like its own smart beast, and you have no influence to tell it that it should run. You can only give it recommendations, but you have no guarantee that the garbage collector will ever run, and so you also have no guarantee that the finalize method will ever run. Yeah, and what would you usually do in a finalize method? The idea was you would also clean up stuff there, just not memory related resources, but not memory related resources. For example, if you have a connection to some I/O resource, like a database or a file, those are also system resources, and all resources are limited. So if you don't want to get in trouble, and if you don't want that your system totally freezes, you have to, again, free up resources when you don't need them anymore. So the idea was to do that in a finalize method. Now the flaw is you don't have a guarantee that it runs. And this already says it's not working as intended. Okay, besides, Joshua Block also gives other reasons. For example, he somehow measured that creating an object and destroying it again is 430 times slower when you have a finalizer method implemented. So again, don't use it. And now let's jump into the IDE and look at it in more detail from a practical point of view. Okay, also, just before, in the API documentation, you might have seen this method is actually protected. Here again, we can see it, protected void finalize. I mean, this Java API is just written into the source code. Here you can see the source code of object.java. So you see it's also just a regular Java class. And you also see this method is empty. This is what I said. It's a hook method. The idea is that you override the method and that you provide code that is executed for cleaning up non-memory resources. And Java tried to prevent that you directly call the finalize method, because as I said, the idea is that you don't call it, but that the JVM calls it for you. So this is why this method is actually protected. Protected is quite hard to understand. One way you can use a method that is protected is if you are in the same package. So let's check. This class is in the package Java lang. So I thought, being nasty, I can just as well create a class in this package. And this is what I did. Here, test Java in package Java lang. You see, everything seems fine. I don't have any exception from the compiler. So now let's try to call this method. And you see, this.finalize seems to be working. I mean, this is not working because this is a static method. So we would actually need a non-static method, or I could also say new object. Well, there is an exception because it can throw a throwable, as we see here at the bottom. I'm not going to handle this now because I only wanted to show you from a theoretical point of view, this is possible. There's just one problem. Let me now surround it with a try catch to get the compiler happy. So see, this would be now directly calling finalize from a class that is in package Java lang. So I'm within my public static void main method. So I execute it. Bam, I get an exception, security exception. It's prohibited. I cannot use Java lang as a package name. So this is not working. Okay, I just thought I should show you. I think this is quite interesting. Now let's close this again. And let's completely remove this method. Okay, so what you should also know, I mean, I said object is the root class, but it's also a concrete class. You can create objects of the class object. What I don't like here is that the word object is used twice, because the class is called object. That's a bit confusing. So anyway, you see, you can call all those methods, but here within the class car selector, we cannot call the finalize method. Okay, so for this I have here this Porsche class. Let's also close the object class. And now let's override the finalize method. Public void finalize without any parameter. So to override a method, it is very important that you do it exactly like in the superclass. The only difference is, and this is allowed, I don't make it protected anymore. I can make it public because public is more visible than protected. This is fine. Okay. And now the idea would be that in here I do clean up my resources. Let's imagine I had some IO reader. IO reader. Reader. I'm not going to implement this, just so that you get the idea. So the idea was that within here, you would, like, for example, close those resources. For this, usually IO readers provide a close method. Now there are several problems. For one, I said, you don't have a guarantee that this method is ever called. This is totally in control by the JVM, and you can not influence that. It's running out of your control. It's running asynchronously. And therefore, it doesn't really serve our purpose. Second flaw is, if within here we have an exception that is not called, the process here will be stopped and our objects will remain in some weird, let's say, zombie state. Yeah. Okay, so the question is, what's the alternative then to using the finalize method? The alternative would be, if you have a class that that uses resources that you want to be closed before it's cleaned up, you could provide, like I told you here, the IO reader would do. You could and you should provide some close method. And then in here you do clean up IO resources. Not going to implement this now. And then let's make this compilable. In car selector, let's imagine this was a client of using Porsche. When we have Porsche, Porsche, new Porsche, you use a try finally. We talked about exception handling already. And I think there in this episode, I told you also, you can say try catch and finally, but you can also use the finally without a catch. Now, if we need a catch or not, this is a different discussion. What is important is that at the end you have a finally, because the finally, the cool thing about the finally, even when there is an exception happening, it will always be executed. Because this was our problem, we need to make sure that the non-memory resources get cleaned up. Okay, so try. Finally. And then in here, we could say Porsche.close to clean up the resources. This is how you properly do it in Java. Okay. Also, shortly, let me show you what I think is interesting. Let's go back what I had before. And the finalize method. What I also want you to know is, I mean, I said we are overriding the method from the class object, which is empty. And there's actually an annotation that is quite helpful here. And this is the annotation, the override annotation. See, when I put the add, there is override. So about annotations, we haven't talked a lot yet. So let me explain that in short. This is actually some meta information for your compiler. that you say, well, my intent here is I want to override some method. If this has a different name, some other name, here you see you get an exception. Method does not override any method from its superclass. Now you might not understand what this helps us. So let's again call it finalize. Now the thing is, you only override a method if the signature is the same as in the superclass. Now if I add the parameter here, this is not overriding anymore, but overloading the method. Because it's just a method that has the same name, but as it has a different parameter, it has a parameter string and not no parameter, this is not overriding anymore. And now we get a compile error, so you will directly notice. So this helps us to have the problem directly at compile time while we're still in our IDE, and we will not, because otherwise it could happen, you think you have implemented a method while you have not, and then you're still using the superclass method, and this you would only see when your code runs on production. So this is why whenever you override something, add this override annotation. Okay, so I think this is pretty much it, talking about the finalize method. In short, again, generally speaking, don't use it. Instead, to free up non-memory resources, use a try finally. Okay, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to give me your thumbs up for the video. This would be really nice. And you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. And last but not least, leave me a comment. Tell me what you did or did not understand, what you liked or did not like, so that I can improve my videos for you. Okay, thanks and bye.